Hello everyone, welcome to a new onWILD video. My name is Diogo Oliveira. I'm a biologist and a wildlife photographer. I'm currently in Brazil exploring the Atlantic rainforest in search for the most amazing animals that I can find. In this video, I'll be searching for one of the slowest mammals that we can find on the planet, which is a three-toed sloth. As you can see, it's not easy to spot them in the dense forest like this. So I have to search very carefully and I have to try to find a sloth inside one of these trees. So normally I can spot them on top of the trees, so that's where I mainly search, but sometimes they are right here on this area, which is the best area for filming. Normally I prefer to use the binoculars because it's easier to spot them. If they are moving, we can see the movement, but if they are sleeping, we don't see anything. We just see a big ball of fur. So it's easier to spot them with the binoculars, and I can search rapidly across the forest instead of using the camera to search for them. Oh look, I found one. There's one over there. Right over there. This is a brown-throated three-toed sloth. And although they are slow, they are fascinating animals. They are even considered one of the most extreme animals on the planet. Let's find out more about them. Sloths are the slowest mammals on the planet, with a top speed of less than a half kilometer per hour. That's because they are almost blind, and during the day, they can see because it's too much bright for them. So moving slowly allows them to not fall from the tree. But it also helps to save them energy, especially when their diet consists of plant leaves all year long, which are low on energy as a snack. Being slow also helps them avoid being detected by predators. Because they are so slow, the predators can't detect their movement. Here's where they go to the extreme. They can rotate their heads by 270 degrees, allowing them to smell the predators from any direction. The brown-throated tree sloth sleeps, mates, and gives birth while hanging upside down on a tree. But hanging upside down all day requires some pretty extreme adaptations. They have special tendons on their hands that lock into place when they need to, which along with their hook-like fingernails allows them to hang on branches easily. But if you ever hang upside down too much, you will likely get dizzy because of all the blood rushing into your head. Well, sloths have developed special valves to stop the rush of blood to their heads, allowing them to hang upside down all day long. Now to poop, they have to risk their lives, climbing down from the protection forest canopy to the ground. Luckily, this only happens once a week, and they can lose up to 30% of their weight each time they go. also be used to find the mate. The pheromones released are left on the base of their favorite trees and are a signal to other sloths in the area. But the most amazing thing about sloths is that their rough fur has its own ecosystem. Because their main habitat is the rainforest, its fur is often very wet, creating a perfect environment for algae to grow, which at the same time provides the sloths with green camouflage. But you can find many creatures living in its fur, and there's one, which is a species of moth, that only lives in its fur and has never been found elsewhere. But their fur could potentially save lives. Fungi that grows on their fur can be used to fight breast cancer and may also fight malaria. So, even though they are slow, they are not boring animals. And sometimes they aren't even that slow. Look how it scratches its back. Let's take a moment to thank our sponsor of this video, which is onWILD. So at onWILD, wait, that's me. So at onWILD.net, you can find guided photography tours around the world. You can find photography tutorials, and you can also buy prints or buy licenses for the digital copies of my images. So every photo that you saw on this video, you can buy it at onWILD.net. You can also find my biology services, like writing wildlife guides or lectures about biology. So don't forget to check onWILD.net, and let's get back to the video. We'll be right back. It's not easy to photograph sloths, as they prefer to stay hidden between the leaves or on the canopy of the trees, which can be a few meters high. So finding one at our level is like finding a needle in a haystack. It took me more than 20 days to finally be able to do so. And I have a good eyesight, practically finding a sloth every day. Now to the camera settings. How dark can a rainforest be? Well, darker than I would imagine. So even though I found a sloth, I had to wait for the perfect light conditions. In this case, I was able to use an ISO of 2000, one for 1000 speed, and an aperture of 6.3. I did not use the tripod for these photos, but I had the image stabilization on, so it helped me a bit. You also must remember to take your raincoat with you, because yes, it's a rainforest and it can start raining heavily all of a sudden, so you must be prepared to at least protect your camera gear, because it's warm, so the rain is a little bit warm. You'll not get cold, you'll get wet, yes, but you'll not get cold, so it's not a cold rain shower, it's really a warm rain shower. So just get something to cover the camera so that all the gear and all the lenses and camera can stay dry and functionally all the time that you need. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you learned a little bit more about the sloths. Don't forget to take photos and share them with the world. Cheers and have a wild day. Thank you.